Hey guys, to begin with, I'm going to start off with my skin care. So I'm going to apply my Tony Moly Goat Milk Placenta Cream. This is super hydrating and moisturizing cream. I think this is amazing for winters because I have seen the difference. My skin has become much bright and soft. Next, I'm going to apply Skin Dinavia Skin Spray Primer. This is just a simple step primer. You just need to spray it on your face and you are done. Next, for the foundation, I'm going to use my all-time favorite drugstore Revlon Color Stay Foundation in the shade 370 Toast. With the help of a damp beauty blender, I am going to apply it in the stamping motion all over my face, and I'm going to keep in mind the uneven skin tone and a little bit of acne and pimple marks that I have around my mouth. So I'm going to damp 2 coats of foundation on those areas. Next, I'm going to use NYX Sculpt and Highlight Duo as a concealer, brightener and contour today. Not for contour, just for sculpt and highlight. So I'm going to apply it under the eyes areas, on my forehead, bridge of my nose, on my cupid's bow, on my chin, as well as on hollows of my cheek to brighten up my face. With the help of the pointed side of the beauty blender, I'm going to fix the product into the place so that it helps to give my skin that brightening effect. For the contouring, I'm using MAC Cosmetics Charlotte Olympia Collection Cream Color Base in the shade Sepia. It is a cream contour kit which has multi-usage. You can use it for contouring. So I'm going to apply it with the help of a big shadow brush on the sides of my face, like on my jawline and all hollows of my cheek, sides of my forehead, as well as on the sides of my nose and on the center of my nose. Then again, with the help of my damp beauty blender, I'm going to blend this onto the places so that I have this shadow like effect on my face, and it also helps to slim down your face. And contouring and highlight is something that I have been loving lately, and if you are a beginner at makeup, I would suggest you to go for a powder contour, but once you get practiced with that, you can move on with cream contouring. Next, I'm going to use Ben Nye's Luxury Powder, which is shade Banana. This is a very nice highlighter. It totally helps to mattify the whole face. I have oily to combination skin, so I like to use it because it helps to make my makeup look more matte. Next, for the face, I'm going to use Sephora's Matte Tan Caramel Toffee Shade, which is a mattifying compact foundation powder which has 8 hours long lasting mattifying finish. I love to use it because it keeps my skin oil free. So I just apply it all over my face and it gives double coverage. Next, I'm going to use Bahama Mamas from Next, I'm going to use Bahama Mamas from the Balm Cosmetics, and I'm going to just put it on top of my cream contouring. This is a very nice bronzer and it gives you very nice sculpt finish to your makeup. So I'm going to apply it with the contour brush on the sides of my nose, jawline, cheeks and forehead, the areas where I like to contour my face. Next, I'm going to use Anastasia Beverly Hills Deep Brow Pomade. It is a medium brown shade cream brow product. So I'm just going to apply it with the help of a small angled brush and fill in my eyebrows. I am also going to use Too Faced Shadow Insurance, which helps your makeup or eye makeup to last for 24 hours. It's basically an eyeshadow primer which helps to make your eyeshadows or eye makeup look more vibrant, and it also helps to give you that crease flawless finish. I'm going to use Makeup Geek and Manny Makeup Artist palette for this look. This is one of my favorite palettes. So the first eyeshadow that I'm going to pick up is called Sora, which has an orange tone in it, and it is a very matte eyeshadow. So I'm going to apply it on top of my crease area using a thick blending brush, and you see there is a bit of orange hues to this look, so I love that. It is perfect for fall and holiday season or for winter. Next, I'm going to pick up this shade called Artemis, and it is a very dark brown matte chocolate color. So I'm going to apply it with the help of a pencil brush on the sides of my or the outer V of my eyelids, and I'm just going to gently blend it as well. And I'm also going to add a couple of coats in here so that I can intensify this whole look. Next, I'm going to pick up this eyeshadow, which has a very nice bronzy shade. This one is called Luna, and I'm going to apply it on the inner corner of my eyelids. Next, I'm going to pick up this Bella bronzer shade, which is a very nice metallic eyeshadow. It is a gel powder eyeshadow from Milani Cosmetics, and I'm going to apply it on the center of my eyelids between the previous two eyeshadows, and I'm going to make sure that I blend it well with the other two eyeshadows. This helps to give your overall makeup look more metallic finish. Metallic makeup is so much in trend right now, and metallic lipsticks, metallic nail polishes or eyeshadows, everything is back in trend this year, so I thought of adding that metallic color to my eyelids. Next, I'm going to pick up this Aphrodite eyeshadow from the same palette, and I'm going to apply it very close to my lower lash line and blend it. This helps to give your overall makeup look more glam look. Even if you are a beginner, it is much easier than applying an eyeliner. Just add a little bit of eyeshadow on your lower lash line and blend it, and it will basically help you to open up your eyes. On top of that eyeshadow, I'm also going to add this little bit of Bella bronzer from Milani. And just this helps to give it more glammed up, glittery, metallic finish to the overall look. And basically this helps to blend up the whole eye makeup and brighten up your eyes. Next, I'm just going to go back to my crease area, and I'm just going to make sure that I blend out that orangish matte Sora eyeshadow very well. There is no harsh line and my eyeshadow is well blended and it has that orange tone to it. Next, I'm going to pick up Ofra Cosmetics highlighter. This one is called Beverly Hills, and this is my favorite highlight palette because it has 5 shades of different highlighters. I'm going to pick up this pale highlighter from the same palette, and I'm going to use the same highlighter to highlight my brow bone under the eyebrows. It helps to give you more glammed up eye makeup look. With the same highlighter, I'm going to highlight the inner corner of my eyelids or the tear duct area to brighten up the whole eye makeup and open up my eyes more. This is a great tip for small eyes. If you have smaller eyes, always highlight your inner corner of the eyelids. This helps to make your eyes look really bigger and bolder. Then I'm going to use the same highlight to highlight my face. So finally, I'm going to apply it on top of my cheekbones, on the center of my nose bridge, or also on the tip of my nose bridge. Also on my cupid's bow and a little bit off on my chin area, and make sure you blend it. Highlighting is something which you have to really control because I love highlighters a lot and I have to control at some point, otherwise it will be all sparkle, glitter all over my face. So I'm just going to make sure that I blend it well, and when the light hits on my face, it will actually give me that shiny, healthy looking skin look. For the blush, I thought of going more matte and natural, so I thought of picking up this Rimmel London blush, which is a matte powder blush. This is shade 121 Amber. I so love it. It is one of the nude and matte and very natural looking blush, so I thought of applying it on my makeup today. So with the help of an angled blush brush, I'm going to apply it on the apples of my cheeks. For the lips, I chose this NYX Cosmetics matte lipstick. This one is called Alabama, one of my favorite shade because it has this mix of red, orange and brown undertone to it. It is a very nice brightening matte lipstick which really lasts longer. Even when I eat or drink, it stays on my lips for a really long time and I don't have to touch it up. Finally, to conceal my lipstick and to finish up my lip makeup, I'm going to use this Too Faced Cosmetics Perfect Lips shade Perfect Red lip liner. I'm just going to apply it on the outlines of my lips so that I can make sure that my lipstick doesn't bleed. Next, I just went ahead and added that little bit of highlighter on top of my Cupid's bow with the help of my fingers very carefully so that I don't put it on my lipstick, and just blend it with a fluffy blending brush. Next, for the eyeliner, I'm going to use Maybelline's Hyper Matte Liquid Liner, and I'm just going to apply very simple thin eyeliner today because I wanted to make this look very simple. So I'm just going to apply a very simple thin layer of eyeliner, and that's all. And I'm just going to add a couple of coats of mascara. I'm going to use Too Faced Cosmetics Better Than Sex new mascara, and this is my ultimate favorite mascara all time. So I'm going to add a couple of coats of it on my upper and lower lashes, and I'm going to skip eyelashes today because I wanted to make this look more simple for you guys. If you don't like to do your eyeliner, or if you're not perfect in doing your eyeliner, and if you don't know how to wear your lashes perfectly, so I thought of doing this look without any difficult winged eyeliner or any glammed up false lashes. And if you basically apply a couple of coats of mascara for your Indian eyes, I think basically your mascara is enough. You don't need fake lashes. Finally, to seal my makeup and to make my makeup last longer, I'm going to use Scandinavia Makeup Finishing Spray. This helps to basically make your full makeup fixed up in your face for a long time, and it does not sweat out or melt out or fade away, and it lasts for a longer time. This completes the whole makeup look. I hope you guys enjoyed this easy glam makeup. Thank you so much for watching. And if you liked and enjoyed, please give this video a thumbs up. Also, leave your comments below. Do not leave this video without commenting below and liking this video. And if you haven't subscribed yet, guys, please subscribe to my channel. It means a world to me. And I will catch you guys very soon in my next one. Bye. I love you all. Bye.